Hi, I had an amazing, very exciting tour of the Animal Medical Center. It says advanced treatment, research, education, devotion since 1910. It's amazing. I know some of you love celebrities, so I want to tell you I saw Mickey Rourke's photograph. He had written a thank you note. It was on the wall. I'm going to show you a photo of that. I'm also thinking of Doris Day, because Doris Day, very early on, devoted herself to animals and has a foundation. I'll give you the link. And today, I just had to say, I'm looking at my cats and I love them, and people can disappoint, but pets don't disappoint you. Dogs, cats, and the Animal Center treats all kinds of exotic animals as well. So I'm gonna tell you about that, and they also have programs to help people if there's financial problems. So I hope you enjoy and sit back and let me know what you think. Thank you.
Wheelbarrow where he's bringing his dog, and it says dispensary for animals, a vitamin treatment. And so that's how the Animal Medical Center got its start. Really started with a group of women who were concerned about living conditions and care expenses, because as you can imagine based on the picture back in those days, that's how it got around. I love this photo of the Animal Medical Center. It's one of the few photos that actually gets the whole building in a photo.
Right.
And it's a gift from a friend of mine who was flying over in a helicopter. So we're open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. No one has a key to the front door because it's never been locked. And we have an enormous caseload and a motivated clientele. And those two features, the enormous caseload and the motivated clientele, have led us to what our mission really is. And AMC has a tri-part mission. The first part of our mission is teaching. So we're well known for training the next generation of specialists. But we also work and offer programs to train our veterinary colleagues. And we also train, educate people in the community. And this is an event that we did last week at the Chapin School on 90th Street.
Yeah.
We had 200 girls, K to 3, and we talked about how to be safe around dogs. And I'll tell you, they really didn't care about seeing me, but boy, did they want to pet those dogs.
Sure.
Allison was with me, and the girls at the end of the assembly rushed to the stage. The teacher's like, stop, stop, stop. So, you know, we do things like this to community education
Sure.
as well. Part of our education mission is that we offer residencies, which is training the next generation of specialists in medicine and cardiology. American Board of Veterinary Practitioners, we offer a residency intermittently in avian medicine, emergency critical care, surgery, and pathology, which is actually, pathology is the oldest specialty college in veterinary medicine. Second part of AMC's mission is research. And one thing that clients are always worried about this mission, because they say, oh, you're going to experiment on my pet. We have so many sick animals that come here. We don't need to experiment on anything. We need to figure out how to make those animals better, faster, and longer. And so our whole mission surrounding research has to do with treating naturally occurring diseases that we see. And so cat with chronic kidney disease. And Dr. Boyd and Dr. Langston were able to identify factors that predict that your cat will do better or worse when they have kidney disease, simply by studying the cats that we saw here. And then finally, we have the bottom one is a combination of two chemotherapy drugs to treat lymphoma when it relapses. Lymphoma is the most common disease that we treat with chemotherapy in veterinary medicine. And so this is just looking at two drugs combined together to see if that it results in a longer survival. And then probably the biggest part of our mission is really clinical service. So AMC has a full service referral or specialty hospital with over 20 specialists. And then we have a general practice as well.
Business, and he worked on the wrestler.
Look, Mickey Rourke. Mickey Rourke.
To try to focus the radiation down on the tumor, we'll take a CAT scan, and then we'll set up a treatment plan based on that CAT scan. And then what we can do is we can use this to shape the beam to the patient. Look through the, so anywhere where the light is coming out, that's where your radiation is going to come out when you actually go to treat the patient. So for this is a dog who has an anal sac tumor. We're actually treating those are tumors that start in the hind end and they usually will spread to lymph nodes under the spine. So we're using this to treat the lymph nodes, which is the front part of this field, and then the perianal area. So this field is used to shape the radiation.
So there's CT scan, MRI, I-131 for hyperthyroid cat, and then central areas uses an oncology treatment area.
Dentistry on a rabbit.
We see that more and more these days with the economy the way it is, and more people need more care for their pets. So that's where our community funds step in. On average, we see through the community funds about 400 pets a year, and the last 2 years, that's been about a little under $1.5 million of care that we have helped families receive for their pets. So it's a big deal. It's something that, as Wendy said, I'm in the development department, and it's something that we try to raise money for every day. Through donations, through the general public. So we're always asking people for help so that we can help others. We also raise money for, as I talked about earlier, for the research and education. But charity programs are something that we're needing more than ever. We also have counseling at the AMC, group counseling for grief or helping to deal with the difficulty of a situation with your pet, and also a pet outreach program where any animal you can imagine goes out to either seniors or others that need a little boost, if you will. We have a bunny that goes out, I think a couple of birds that go out, and we hear the most fabulous stories of people that are, they don't know how to get out of themselves. They, either stay locked in a room or they won't speak. They just don't know how to react to people, but as soon as an animal comes into their room, they light up and everything changes in their world. So it's, the same thing that, I'm sure your dog does to you, is no matter how good or bad your day was, as soon as you get home and see your pet at the door, everything else goes away. You just have that unconditional love. And so that's another big part of what we do here. So I don't want to talk too much through your lunch. Sure.
Could you list again the community organizations or groups you help?
Sure. It's PAF is the Patient Assistance Fund. SAVE is the one for seniors. And then we also care for the guide dogs in the tri-state area. There's also another fund that I didn't mention, which is the Buddy Fund, which is for cancer care. And that's a smaller fund, just because it's so geared towards cancer care in animals.
Okay.
Those are our four main.
Thank you.
Sure.
Thank you for listening, and there's so much I didn't get to share, including a very moving story of how I came to love the Animal Medical Center, and it was actually through the Fifth Avenue specialists. It was an emergency, a beloved cat I adopted just 2 years ago at age 10. It's a whole story, and I'll tell you another time, but between Fifth Avenue and Animal Medical Center, they saved her life.